Hello. It's fresh air. On another one. It's cold out and it's snowing. Yeah. So, today's message is about when you were a child, bringing that child within yourself to the forefront of today. Now, when I think back of all the holidays and things like that, when I was younger, now that was my fascination of life. That was what you were told at that time. For instance, you know, I grew up in a Catholic church with my family. I was an altar boy. I'm thinking back of all the times I used to believe. Because when you're a child, you're only given what you've been told, right? And the experiences are still yet to be experienced. So, at 8, 9 years old, when you're still believing in Santa Claus, you still remember coming out after midnight mass on Christmas, looking at the sky for Santa Claus, like he's on a sleigh. And his reindeer is all going around. And the fascination that comes with it when you were a child. Now, today's society seems to lose, or it seems that once you get older, you seem that the world isn't operating on the same wavelength. Or got diverted from the people around me, right? Now, the child within you is still there. Once you start tapping into your child within you, from when you were back in the days and your conscious self and your understanding of what life was then. Isn't it fascinating going back and thinking of yourself when you were a child? I mean, in the good parts. I mean, we all have times in our lives that we go back and we listen or we look at and we see things. We experience them a certain way. I'm here to tell you that as a child, you don't have to hold on to things or feel wrong like it could have been different if you would have done this different or that's different. Or this different. I'm here to tell you that you were a child and that you made decisions based on what you were given, what's been presented to you as a child. And so with that said, at 8, 9 years old, we all experience things differently, I guess, right? Some had to, at 8 years old, already be babysitting their sister or their brother. Some were given responsibilities way earlier than they were supposed to. And they were fending for themselves, for food, just to survive. Now, my situation and your situation is, obviously, our realities are different in how we are raised in a time we were raised. You get what I'm saying? So if my 8 years old was in 1989 or 88, 89, you know, because I was born December 8th, that's a different 8 year old. You get what I'm saying? If you take and think about today, we didn't have the internet. We didn't have the internet to look up things or experience things faster, more abruptly, more given to you with here, this is how we see it. And this is what the world is doing as collectively. But I think that child within you can help you today, where you can go back and look at the innocence you were the innocence of not feeling wronged, not feeling less than, not feeling like you don't fit in. But you were always the one to raise your hand, to ask a question. You were always the one to help people when you could. You were opening the door for people. You knew something was special about you. See, for me, I was given the opportunity to feel like I was a part of something. And that was God. I was an altar boy. And I served as when I first got my first communion. I asked, you know, the sister that was in charge of the altar boys, a nun, that I was ready. And I want to be an altar boy. This is what I was destined to be, is to serve. My love for God was my understanding early on. So, when I look back at the child within me, I look at like how innocent I was and how oblivious I was to the world. That unfortunately, the world is not exactly how it is. Now, we can always step back and look at some of the things we've done wrong. I get that. And we can feel bad and sad and feel like we get into a shadow or a storm when we start looking at that stuff. But really what I'm trying to do is make way for the person that I once was, where I have that passion to help others. Yes. That passion to help others believe in themselves. I was a young entrepreneur when I was a young child. I think I was 11. I started doing mowing grass around the neighborhood. And I was making some money doing that. Now that passion and that drive, I wish I had today. And that's why it's somewhat important to sometimes go back and look at the good things. The drives that we had, the experiences we had, that maybe as we grew up, we misunderstood, or we were told we're different, we're less than, we're this, we're that. And there comes a point in your life where you now are no more longer innocent because now you are affected by somebody else. Now, like I say, everybody's situation and what they go through is different. But me, the child within you and me, can better transform ourselves today, moving forward. Use it as a tool to better understand yourself, to better reinvent yourself, to better recreate yourself to that person you once were. Now, some people would be like, oh, well, you were too sheltered. Well, maybe that was a good thing. Maybe I needed to be sheltered because I needed to experience at least that moment in my life where I felt a part of something. I was a part of God. And my first love was God. My passions to serve and care and love and respect others and love and respect my elders, love and respect and listen to the ones that have done this life before. So when I was a child, I used to absorb it like a sponge. A lot of the old timers used to come to me and talk to me because they used to think, he can listen. I see something special in him. So the lesson for today and this speak or this prophetic message is don't give up on trying to find who you are. Don't give up on your gifts. Don't give up on your passions. Don't give up on your purpose in life. That the child within you is screaming for some attention. Say, hey, remember me? Remember me? I'm still here. And this is just a blessing because today I felt like I connected to that. I took a moment to remember when I first remember the snowfall, when I used to go sliding. I used to remember all the passionate times I used to go with my friends and go in the snow and make snow angels. I want to go back to that child within me and say, you know what? You are an amazing person. You're an amazing child with gifts. Today, I want you to softly kind of, if you haven't done it a lot, but give it a chance to go back and look at those good times, if you had them. Try to focus on those. Push aside some of the death setbacks that weren't in your control. You know, remember your responsibility as a child. It's you looked up to every adult damn near. I mean, I did. I soaked it up. And see, being sheltered helped me just listen all the time to people. But when you listen, sometimes the message given, things go astray because either we start getting told we are a certain kind of way, we're special, you're not going to amount to anything, or, you know, there's setbacks that were in your timeline for a reason. I know that's hard to say, but it's true. God is good. God is great. He just gave me a great message today, and I just wanted to share that with you. And thank you so much for listening, and I hope that you have a wonderful day, and that I pray that no weapon formed against you will prosper, and that you will have everlasting life as long as you believe that a power greater than yourself will help transfer you to your next level of your purpose, and that nothing will get in your way from continuing practicing what you are here to do. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.